Hello, my name's Mark O'Mara and I wanted to share a little bit about an activity that I did with one of my Year 10 English groups, and it was getting them to write a simple story in the constructed language Esperanto. Now, the reason that we're doing this is fairly simple. This English subject is an English language subject, and that's something akin to linguistics, where you're looking at language structure and purpose and what languages have in common and so forth. So Esperanto is perfect for this because it has a very clear purpose, and it's actually a very logical language. English can be so just baffling in spots that when you talk about grammar, there are so many exceptions and everything, whereas Esperanto being constructed is very logical. So it's a good kind of launching pad for a lot of those concepts. I've taught this before, but from the get-go, I actually wanted to do this as puzzle-based, kind of not so much me just projecting the knowledge, but letting them nut it out themselves. And because it's logical, that seemed like a good thing to do. You know, they could uncover the logic. So we did a crossword where they could build up some vocabulary and decode some basic sentences. And I have to say that was all going really well. So they were working towards getting the capacity to write this story. Now, of course, if you're going to do a story, you need some tools. I thought, well, rather than just me saying, here's a bunch of words, you go work out what tools that you're going to use. A story out of this, because that is very limiting. I thought, no, I'll give them access to stuff to make it a bit more fun. So I booked the computers. This is a little bit tricky to do at the school that I'm at, but I booked ahead, I think 2 weeks ahead, got the computers for the sessions. When we got there, I'd put the resources on my class blog, Red Space Rocket, so that I always do this, so we're not wasting time with me handing out links and so forth. You just go there and that tells you where on the internet you need to go. So, first place we went was this fantastic site called Storybird. It looks a bit for primary school kids, but it's playful and it's fun. And so we were going to use that to build our storybooks. And it's wonderful. I highly recommend it. The second thing I gave them was an online dictionary. Now, there are a few online dictionaries for Esperanto, but I'd used this one before and it works pretty well. They did end up using others, but I figure it's worth giving them a primary resource. So those were the tools. Now, I'd also wanted to talk about, you know, what happened. Now, here's the good news. The good news is that some students really leapt into this and had a good go. They wrote their stories in English, and then they went back and they wrote it in Esperanto. Now, this particular story here is probably the most impressive effort from the class, from young Maddie, and it's really, really good. I thought that she'd done, you know, some of it, and I looked through, and it's really, really extensive. It's very, very impressive. So that's the high end, but not many people got to the high end, and it's unfortunately a really simple reason why they didn't. The very simple reason that they didn't get there is that the computers failed us. We had a bunch of computers available. Everybody should have had one of their own, but about a third of the machines weren't working. We are going through infrastructure issues, but once you take 30% of your machines out and a further probably 20%, the internet was so slow, like it would take 5 minutes to respond to something, so that they were basically unusable. And for a task like this, where you're so dependent on the IT tools, you know, we don't have books of Esperanto vocabulary in our school library. So it was either you get it off the internet or you don't have it at all. So while we did have some students getting some really good work done, we did have probably a third of the class who got nothing substantive done. And that was really, really frustrating. You know, I will try this again down the track, but it won't be soon. Anyhow, so that's the end. I have to say it was a bit disappointing in the end, but it's a task that I'll come back to in some form in the future, because I think there's value in it. It just didn't work this time.